brushwood was lighted, and when the flames were burning very high, the woman said, "Now, children, lay yourself down by the fire and rest. We will go into the forest and cut some wood, and when we have done, we will come back and fetch you away." Hansel and Gretel sat by the fire, and when noon came, each ate a little piece of bread, and as they heard the strokes of the wood axe, they believed that their father was near. It was not the axe, however, but a branch which he had fastened to a withered tree, which the wind was blowing backwards and forwards. And as they had been sitting such a long time, their eyes closed with fatigue and they fell fast asleep. When at last they awoke, it was already dark night, and Gretel began to cry and said, "How are we to get out of the forest now?" But Hansel comforted her and said, "Just wait a little until the moon has risen, and then we will soon find the way." And when the full moon had risen, Hansel took his little sister by the hand and followed the pebbles, which shone like newly coined silver pieces, and showed them the way. They walked the whole night long, and by break of day came once more to their father's house, and they knocked at the door, and when the woman opened it and saw that it was Hansel, she said, "You naughty children, why have you slept so long in the forest? We thought you were never coming back at all." The father, however, rejoiced, for it had cut him to the heart to leave them behind alone. Not long afterwards, there was once more great dearth throughout the land, and the children heard their mother saying at night to their father, "Everything is eaten again. We have only half a loaf left, and that is the end. The children must go. We will take them farther into the wood so that they will not find their way out again. There is no other means of saving ourselves." The man's heart was heavy, and he thought, "It would be better for you to share the last mouthful with your children." The woman, however, would listen to nothing that he had to say, but scolded and reproached him. "He who says A must say B likewise." And as he had yielded the first time, he had to do so a second time also. The children, however, were still awake and had heard the conversation. When the old folks were asleep, Hansel again got up and wanted to go out and pick up pebbles as he had done before. But the woman had locked the door, and Hansel could not get out. Nevertheless, he comforted his little sister and said, "Do not cry, Gretel. Go to sleep quietly. The good God will help us." Early in the morning came the woman and took the children out of their beds. Their piece of bread was given to them, but it was still smaller than the was, in reality, a wicked witch who lay in wait for children and had only built the little house of bread in order to entice them there. When a child fell into her power, she killed it, cooked it, and ate it, and that was a feast for her. Witches have red eyes and cannot see far, but they have a keen scent, like the beasts, and are aware when human beings draw near. When Hansel and Gretel came into her neighborhood, she laughed with malice and said mockingly, "I have them. They shall not escape me again." Early in the morning, before the children were awake, she was already up, and when she saw both of them sleeping and looking so pretty with their plump and rosy cheeks, she muttered to herself, shriveled hand and carried him into a little stable and locked him in behind a grated door. Scream as he might, it would not help him. Then she went to Gretel, shook her till she awoke, and cried, "Get up, lazy thing, fetch some water and cook something good for your brother. He is in the stable outside and is to be made fat, and when he is fat, I will eat him." Gretel began to wept bitterly, but it was all in vain, for she was forced to do what the wicked witch commanded. And now, the best food was cooked for poor Hansel, but Gretel got nothing but crab shells. Every morning, the woman crept to the little stable and cried, "Hansel, stretch out your finger that I may feel if you will soon be fat." Hansel, however, stretched out a little bone to her, and the old woman, had dim eyes, could not see it, and thought it was Hansel's finger, and was astonished that there was no way of fattening him. When 4 weeks had gone by and Hansel still remained thin, she was seized with impatience and could not wait any longer. "Now then, Gretel," she cried to the girl, "stir yourself and bring some water. Let Hansel be fat or lean. Tomorrow I will kill him and cook him." Sister did lament when she had to fetch the water, and how her tears did flow down her cheeks. "Dear God, do help us," she cried. "If the wild beasts in the forest had but devoured us, we should at any rate have died together." "Just keep your noise to yourself," said the old woman. "It won't help you at all." Early in the morning, Gretel had to go out and hang up the cauldron with the water and light the one happy hour since he had left the children in the forest. The woman, however, was dead. Gretel emptied her pinafore until pearls and precious stones ran around the room, and Hansel threw one handful after another out of his pocket to add to them. Then all the anxiety was at an end, and they lived together in perfect happiness. So, that was it. I love all the detail from the original tale. I think it's just so cute. And I always like how Gretel is the one to save them at the end. She kind of has her moment. It isn't just this helpless little girl like she is in the beginning. Okay. So now still.